the hour, including my next guest, Congressman Ron Paul, who joins us momentarily. First, by way of introduction, he drew a major following when he ran 4 years ago for the GOP nomination. Tonight, he drew a sharp contrast with the other candidates on military involvement abroad. Listen.
I served 5 years in the military. I've had a little experience. I've spent a little bit of time over in the Pakistan, Afghanistan area, as well as in Iran. But I wouldn't wait for my generals. I'm the commander-in-chief. I make the decisions. I tell the generals what to do, and I'd bring them home as quickly as possible, and I'd get them out of Iraq as well, and I wouldn't start a war in Libya. I'd quit bombing Yemen, and I'd quit bombing Pakistan. I'd start taking care of people here at home because we could save hundreds of billions of dollars. Our national security is not enhanced by our presence over there. We have no purpose there. We should learn the lessons of history, and the longer we're there, the worse things are, and the more danger we're in as well, because our presence there is not making friends, let me tell you.
And Congressman Paul joins me now. We just played the response you said about military serving overseas. That really does put you in stark contrast to many of the people on the stage tonight.
Yeah, I think so. It did 4 years ago. But what I sense now...
And you've been consistent all along.
Yeah, and what I sense now is there's not so much of a dramatic difference. If you listen carefully, some of them are coming our way, my way, the way that I believe we should go. But where the real difference is with the people. If you look at the polls and how many people think we should be in Libya and how many people think we ought to get out of Afghanistan. So that's where I feel completely different. Although, you know, I don't obviously have agreement, and my statement was different because I'm rather emphatic, because I think the issue of war is so important that on principle, because it's such a deadly issue. But it's also a major economic issue. I look at it carefully because all great nations usually go down when they spread themselves too far around the world. They go into an empire, then they can't afford it, no matter how well-intentioned it is. And I know those who disagree with me are well-intentioned and think this is very necessary, but financially it's very, very risky. And of course, I pointed out, politically it's a lot easier cutting this overseas spending than it is to go after child health care. And I think that makes a more important point, too.
During the break, Gloria Borger sort of said to you just offhandedly, you know, it's a sense of deja vu being back on this stage, and you said it does feel different. How does it feel different this time?
Well, it felt like I was pushing much harder on the envelope before, and I was so much alone and didn't know what the responses were. And even in the first debate that we had in South Carolina, there was a difference. The reactions are different. And what has happened the last 3 years, it's different. So, no, I think the country now is definitely moving in the direction of less government, a different foreign policy. But it's not like it's my foreign policy. I'd sort of like to say I'm running on the position of George W. Bush's foreign policy in the year 2000. We talked about a humble foreign policy. People like that. But I want it, and they know it, and now it's necessary.
I want to play for our viewers a response you had. You were asked about the role of faith in public life. I want to play for our viewers a response.
Church. I think faith has something to do with the character of the people who represent us. And law should have a moral fiber to it, and our leaders should. We shouldn't expect us to try to change morality. You can't teach people how to be moral. But the Constitution addresses this by saying, literally it says no theocracy, but it doesn't talk about church and state. The most important thing is the First Amendment. The Congress shall write no laws, which means Congress should never prohibit the expression of your Christian faith in a public place.
The last part you said there, Congress shall never prohibit the expression, or no laws which should never prohibit the expression of your Christian faith in a public space. Do you think Christianity is under attack in the United States?
I think to some degree, but well, there are certain pressures put on Christians and made fun of, you know, just subtly. I don't think in a legislative sense, but the one point I was trying to make there is that you can't legislate morality, you know, and that's what a lot of some people want to think we do. We take our morality and we will legislate and make you morally better people. I think that's impossible. But I said what has to have a moral fiber to it is the law has to have a moral basis to it. And also the people who represent us should have moral character. That's how I think our faith should influence them. But the use of force to make people live better. See, I apply that in economics. I apply that to personal things. And I apply that to foreign policy. It'd be nice if we could remake Afghanistan and maybe improve it, but it doesn't work. The blowback is so much, you know, it's so painful that it's much better for us to set a good example with men who have character, men who believe in principles, and then other people may want to emulate us.
Congressman Ron Paul, thank you for your time.
Thank you very much.
Busy day. Thank you.
Thank you.